today this part three. Okay, we already done two NEC chip and one SOT SOT. I don't know what SOT is it. Okay, today we're gonna go over for another three more diode and two more here, five. Okay, after we done the five, we're gonna try to see how to jump wire. Okay, the hardest part is the wire jumping. Let's say you have a broken trace here, then you have a broken trace here, so you need a connection. So we need to solder a very small wire like this one. Okay, this is a 0.1 mm. This is very thin. Okay, we're gonna try to do this. It's not easy, but let's have some fun. Okay, I got five diodes here. The last five. After we're done with this one, then maybe the next video I will try to do using hot air station. Your hot air station, some components are very easy, but if there is a very small component like this type, the filter, let me see where's the filter, the dead solder, okay, this type, or this type, okay, this type, okay, your hot air station will blow away the chip. Once it's blow away already, and it's totally gone to the ninth dimension. So what we're gonna do right now is we apply flux as usual. Every time we start with flux. Okay, and then we grab a component. Look at the arrow. The arrow is going up, so the blue color is heading up. Okay. So to hold the component like this is, you want to solder, let's say either top or bottom, is very hard, okay, because you're holding a component already. So you have to hold this way. So instead of hold this way, we switch the board, so it's more easier. Okay, right now I'm gonna apply some solder on the soldering side, iron. Okay, and let's secure the first part. On my right hand is the tweezer because I'm writing with right hand. Okay, let it go down. Okay, this is secure. So we can do the other side with the soldering iron on the left side. Because my steady hand is on the right side. Okay, done. First part done. So after we practice already like two times, three times, you get used to it. I think you will solder much more faster and you got the momentum going on. Okay. As usual, let me see my solder iron on the right side. Let me apply some solder. Okay, tiny enough. So correct, this one is heading this way, the blue color should be on the left hand side. Okay, done. Wait for it. Okay, cool down, harden. Next, I think we still have some solder. Okay, done. So the third one, okay, the blue color is on the right hand side, so it doesn't matter your hand on the left or right is still the same. Holding tweezer for me as a newbie, I think using the right hand holding a tweezer is better just to secure the first solder connection for the component to stay. Okay, done. See, steady already. Okay, the other side, apply pin solder. Done. Okay, we got two more. This side. Okay, as usual, flux is drugs for soldering. Okay, we got two more diode. Okay, this side. Solder. A tiny bit, okay. Use your writing hand, hold the tweezer tightly, don't let it fly, and just tap. Done. Okay. At the side, we don't have solder, so we're gonna put some solder. Nice one. So the last one is which direction? The blue on the right hand side. Okay. So I'm gonna turn. As you can see, my progress for training this practice board. From day one, my solder skill really sucked and my hand keeps shaking. But today, I'm much better. Okay, ready to cool down. Okay, done. The other side. Okay, let me see where's the head. Okay, where's the head? Okay, done. Let me clean it up. Every time you're done, clean out the flux. Otherwise, the board will be very sticky and it looks ugly. Okay? Ugly like Top Wizard. You know Top Wizard? I think you don't know because you're not a gamer. There's a game I'm playing, and the guy, he called himself very ugly. So it looked like a bunch of flux on the guy's face. I'm just kidding, man. Okay. Clean it up. Okay, let's see. Nice and sturdy. Nice. Good. So, unless you want me to install this sock. Actually, it's just a transistor. I don't know why they call sock. Stand for standard operation. Actually, I don't even know what it called, man. Okay, maybe we just install one more this one and then we go for the wire jumper. Okay. Start with flux. Okay. Flux is your best friend. Okay. A letter is like that. You can see this side. There's a curve. So it should mean pin number one. Okay. Once it's done, as usual, clean your solder tip before doing anything. Apply some solder on the right side. Okay, secure the first leg. see, let me adjust first. Okay, I think this is nice. Let's go the first leg. Oh, not yet. Okay, still moving. Okay, now it's good. I cool down. Oh, still not yet. Don't worry, add more. This one should do it. Okay, see, secure already. And the top side, one tap. Okay, see, okay, now it's good for individual solder. Okay, let me clean up the tip. Is it clean? Yes, nicely clean. Okay, done. Oh, I think we got still got some solder on the tip just now. Done. All right. Is it good? We check it using our tweezer. Solid. 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 And solid. You see? Practice make perfect. I'm getting better and better. So once I get full confidence, then I can start repair the real one. Okay, the real stuff. Oh, I got a lot of motherboard. I got a lot of I got some broken hard disk, which I need to transfer my file. I got a lot of photos. So giving somebody to repair or retrieve hard drive, it costs so much. So if you know how to do, why not just do it your own self? Okay. All you need is the practical skill, micro soldering, because the component is too small. Without training, I have done once without training. I using a cheap soldering tools. I messed up. So I stopped there and I didn't do anything until now my skill is good and I will continue back the repair. Okay. Let's check the leg. Solid, 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 solid. Solid and solid. Okay, good. We are getting much better now. Okay, let's clean up. Clean the flux. Otherwise, it will look very ugly. Okay. Look at this. I mean, this is the first time I start my soldering technique. Okay, look at the joint. It's actually it's very, very ugly, man. You know? So it's good because the more you solder, the better it you get. Okay, this is the first time I solder. The first chip, short chip on my practice spot number 2. This is what I soldered today. Okay, there's a lot of glare. Okay, let me turn like that. See, it's much better, getting better and better. Okay, now we are going to do wire jumping. Wire jumping means I got an EC chip, broken traces. Where is it? Ah, this one. Okay, where is it? Okay, let's say an example. Okay, these traces connected to this area. Okay, so this line broken, and traces here broken. There's a traces here. Let's say example. There's a traces here. So we're gonna do is grind this area until you see the copper. Make a solder. Connect this jumper wire to this part. Okay. That's the real motherboard, but it's not happening in this training board. So now I'm gonna give an example. Let's say. Let's find a suitable one. Okay. Let's say this part gone. Okay. Let's say this part gone. I'm gonna scratch it hard. Scratch it very hard. Okay, let me see, clear it a bit. Okay, example, this part gone, broken, and this need connection to here. Okay, how are we gonna do? It's not deep enough. Let's make it deeper. We take a grinding pan. Let's grill a hole. Let's say grill a hole. Okay. See? Gone. This whole part, no more line. Okay? It's totally empty. So I'm gonna make a connection here to here, or let's say from here to here. How are we gonna do? We need a grinding pan. Okay, we go and grind. Let's say this part. Lightly, don't over grind until you see the copper. Okay, we saw the copper already. Let me see this light, is it better? Okay, I think I'll use this light better. Okay. Grind a bit more. Okay. And let's say we gotta connect from here. Clean it up. Okay, we saw two copper exposed side. Okay, what we're gonna do right now is we're gonna connect this part to this part. So how are we gonna connect first? Okay, of the glare. We put some flux. Okay, flux here and flux here. Okay, and then we're gonna apply solder on the two joint. Okay, let's say here. Okay, there's some not nice, not enough flux. Okay, there's a solder there, and then we're gonna solder here. Okay, we both sides have solder already. Now we're gonna take a solder jumper wire. Let me see how long. Oh my god, it's so thin, I cannot even see with my naked eye, man. Okay, put it here. Okay, this is a wire. So we're gonna make a connection first. Let's say we solder this part. Okay, we clean up the solder tip first. We still have flux. So we're gonna connect here. Okay, is it tight? No. We do it again. No. Actually, connecting jumper wire broken traces repair is the most hard. Okay, we got a secure one. Nice. Nice. So I'm going to take another tweezer. I'll use this tweezer and. Okay, let's say we connect here. Okay. So I'm going to apply solder on this area. Okay, is this secure? Let's check it out. Okay, solid. Okay, so from here, we're gonna cut it out. We're gonna cut it out. Let me see which one. Okay, I'm gonna use a hobby knife. Okay, and cut out this part. Okay, because the wire is so thin, I think it's very easily to get cut. Oh no, it's very hard because I cannot adjust the angle. Okay, done. Let's clean it up. We got this connection right here. It's through here already. So how are we gonna know there's a connection? We're gonna use a multimeter. Let's say set to diode mode. There's a connection from here to this side. Yes, you hear the sound. Yes. Because it's a diode this way, so you can only go from this way. It will never go back. If we go back, that means this diode is spoiled. Faulty. Okay, so there's a connection here. That means successfully you jump the wire to here. Okay, so for a newbie to solder wire jump, it's not easy. Okay, it is really, really, really very hard. Honestly, very, very hard. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna apply solder mask. What do you call this? We call it solder mask. CCTV, actually I'm a Chinese, okay. UV mask. Okay, green. Okay, you're gonna apply a little bit, very tiny, just to protect. Have a broken tweezer. Let me see which one. Okay. Oh, shit. Oh my god. I pressed a little bit and see. Whoa. It's too much, man. Too much. Okay. I'm gonna take a little bit. I'm gonna apply to here. I cover the whole thing so it will not short. See the tweezer is bent already because I forgot what I use and make it spoil already. So we're gonna apply a UV mask here. Oh, never mind, since it's still wet, not yet cured, we can wipe it out easily. Okay, I'll wipe it out here. Okay, done. So how are we going to cure it? We're going to use a UV lamp. We're going to blast some UV there, cover it up for maybe 30-40 seconds, and the UV will cure. But don't look at the UV, man, your eyes will burn out. Okay, let me put back some of the stuff. I don't need a UV light, UV mask. My wire is done. Okay, we wait for the curing process and have fun. So, is micro soldering having fun? I personally say yes, for men, for guys. Because guys like technology, they like some new stuff, they like to repair things, even though they don't know how to repair, they will still try to repair, and at the end, big disaster. It happens to me, it happens to my friend, it happened to a lot of people. Okay, let's see, is it cured? Off the UV lamp first. Okay. Let me clean up this one. Oh, cure already. Hard already. Okay, good. Huh. So fast. Thank you, UV lamp. Okay, UV lamp saved my day. Otherwise, if I just leave it on like that for a whole day, it's still wet. Okay, that's a solder mask. So today we learn how to wire jumping, repair broken traces, although the result is not like factory made, but as a newbie, you still manage to repair it, even though it looks not nice. Honestly, it doesn't look nice, not even like a factory job, but what can you do? You just practice on a third day. So that's it for today's lesson. And tomorrow I might want to solder all this stuff using hot air. I'm gonna try hot air, but I can guarantee you, let's say if I solder 10 of this component resistor with hot air, mostly 3 component will fly to the 9th dimension. Gone. Forever gone. You cannot even find back. Okay. That's it for today. Hope you enjoy the lesson.